I wanted to ask a question, a fundamental question. You had talked about controlling your senses as one of the steps of Raj Yoga. I need a reminder on the other steps of kind of living the path in addition to controlling the senses.
Controlling the past?
Or no, being on the path.
On the path.
Okay.
So like, what are the, aren't there five kind of elements of, is it Raj Yoga?
No. Raj Yoga has eight steps.
Eight, okay. So
first and second, Yama Niyama is like 10 commandments,
okay,
like all the religions have. So you are in harmony with life. That is the foundation. If you are not in harmony with life, eating good food and exercises won't make you healthy. So, living in harmony. In Buddhism, they call dharma, you know, shila. So, dharma, so moral living. So, moral living is the fundamental for everything. Then comes asana, means yoga positions. Yoga positions means working with the body, but working with not only with muscles or joints, but nervous system, heart, lungs, endocrine system. This is yoga. Also including proper nutrition and proper elimination. That means cleansing. That is physical preparation. Then breathing, because subtler than the body is the breath or prana. So working on the breathing. So you refine yourself from gross body to energy body. And then comes controlling the senses and mind. So you get control over the mind. And then mind becomes sharper than you use for expansion to understand. Or you, that called vipassana or vipassana. With a sharper, purer mind, you see reality as is. And what is reality as is? Everything is illusion. That is reality. Reality, we see like I exist as body, but it's illusion because it's relatively real, but ultimately it is born and dies. It just, so seeing it is illusion. So we don't take anything seriously. Anything we own, we have only privilege. Any person we are in relationship, we see they are changing. So we don't hang on to them. So vipassana is seeing impermanence. So if you see impermanence of the things, what is the advantage? You enjoy life fully. You know, why don't we enjoy life fully? Because we try to hang on. If you consider this is temporary, then you would play the life like it is a game. It is a play. It is a play. In the play, you lose or gain, is fun. So this is how we live life. So really, to live the life fully, nothing, to take nothing seriously. And that is same concept of being an observer. Because you become observer, nothing is serious. There is no gain, no loss. You observe. So you are not touched by anything. Okay. So this is the direction. So that has manifold question, like what you want to do is clarity. That's the first thing. Clarity, what you want. And then applying it. See, people want to succeed. They have only thoughts. But you need all this together. See if I can find several things in here. Yeah, so this is this book, I found it. Okay. Specific guidance. If you want to succeed, first you need clarity. Okay. Then, if you have clarity, you have love for what you want to do. See? Because people don't succeed. I want to meditate, but you don't have love for it. I want to do yoga. I want to do fasting. You create love for it. Decision. This is where people waste their energy. You know? Like pendulum, to be or not to be. Make decision. Then make commitment. Make commitment. Set priority. Just the keywords. I'm not explaining. Create urgency, you know. I will do tomorrow. Create urgency. Create intensity. Just I will do this much. No, I want to do more intensity. Then create with creative energy. That means tune into creative energy. Enthusiasm. So this satsang is enthusiasm. Like what we talked on different topic, you know, everyone get inspired and get little enthusiasm. Like I have to practice. Enthusiasm. Patience and perseverance. And don't be anxious. Like you plant the seeds and you want the fruits. So patience and perseverance. And undercurrent, I like that term. Undercurrent, you know, it's just like a ocean has undercurrent. That determines lots of things. So we have undercurrent of what I want. You have desire. You have undercurrent. Externally you do, it doesn't count as much. Undercurrent that you really want, that pushes you. Like you want to eat candy, and that stays undercurrent until you eat. You won't be satisfied. So that is undercurrent. Something that you want, all the time you're thinking. So you have to think day and night. Something you want, that is your life. So businessman thinks about money all the time. Spiritual man thinks about God all the time.
The peace of mind undercurrent was really helpful mind. When you...
Yes, so deep desire. Movie. So many people don't succeed because they don't have undercurrent, just like superficial, borrowed. And then surrender. Surrender mantra we did. After that, surrender to God. Surrender to God means it's just we are interconnected. See that principle? We are interconnected. Whatever your intention is, put it in the universe. And law of attraction, right situation, right people will be attracted to you. Okay. Does that answer your question? So all these things are necessary. I find in general, people get enthusiasm, you know, and that lasts for a while and dies. Then they get into another thing, enthusiasm. So small flow of enthusiasm won't do. Enthusiasm until it goes through this, you know, clarity to I put down all the steps in short. You just look at the steps and you get inspiration. Clarity, decision, love for it, enthusiasm, intensity, urgency, you know, those things. Patience, perseverance, undercurrent, you will succeed.